MG.
MG!
We waited for you and we're live on air now.
What?
We are live on air now. We're on Google Hangouts. And hello, everyone! Greetings. Hey. This is Satek Ananda from Crowbar Cardio. I'm used to saying the body jerking Zendo. We're at Crowbar Cardio for the last session of our Sculpt and Burn workshop here with all these wonderful women. Hello, wonderful women. Hello. Tell us your names, wonderful women.
Sam.
Tammy.
MG.
Toba.
Kim.
Shara.
Beautiful, beautiful. These ladies have done really, really awesome in a very small amount of time, and they're going to do even more awesome today, and they're getting a big surprise. People keep asking me, what can I do at home? Satek, what can I do at home? And I keep telling them, this is what you do at home, right? It's level one workout DVD. No bar. All you need is a ball. Work with any size ball. And that's what we're going to start with today, is the principles of what's called floor work, which is the basis of everything you guys are doing on these bars. It all started just on the floor. We're not going to do it for long. We're just going to do some fun warm-ups so that you can feel the possibilities and not feel like you can't play with a ball unless you have a bar, okay? Because that's not an excuse. And most of my work with the bar started with furniture. I was sitting, you know, my ball at my desk and rolling, doing this and doing that, and it all started with furniture, right? Literally, okay? So we're going to play with that today, and let's get to cracking. We set this is just my laptop and the floor, and hopefully, like, you can see most of the stuff. If not, too bad, so sad. But let's get to go and find a ball. We are not on the walls. Not on the walls.
Is there a ball for me?
Yes, you can grab it.
Perfect. All right. And actually, even before we get the balls, come into the center. Come and put it around the center. Okay. No. We'll be able to see in the reflection. Coming closer. All right. And that's how easy this can be. I was thinking, what do I do, which part or whatever, right? And just like, oh, okay. That's how easy what we're doing is. No thinking, no figuring out, no right, no wrong, just play, okay? Got some crazy-ass music. I want you to let it make you giggle and play with your ball, okay? Let's do it. Nope, not sitting, you're walking. And you're strolling with your ball. And feel the beat in your steps. However that happens. Balance it. There's nothing lower. How low can you go? And lay on your belly. Relaxing over the ball, rocking back and forth gently. Use your breath as you're moving back and forth. Relax the ribs, sternum, spine, the hips. Good. Gently come back in center. all four of the hands and feet or whatever, up to the head, knees on feet. Left hand comes underneath the right. Right hand twists up towards the ceiling. The big stretch up the spine. Take a deep breath. Exhale. Release. Relax. Back down the center. Hand goes to the other side. Right hand goes under the left.
Twisting up the back.
Deep inhale. Relax the spine, the ribs. Good. Back to center. Alright, so those are two points. Now we're going to connect them. Left hand goes under the right. Right hand comes up. And now as best you can do, you're going to go from here all the way to the other side. Switch. Nice. Switch. 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 This is called sway and switch. 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 Beautiful. Back to center. Good. So you're going to let your butt come towards the ground, so you're squatted way down the back. And then we're going to roll over, reach out in front of you, chin drops to the floor, push back straight all the way back to squatting again. Little front roll. Over, drop the chin to the floor, push back. Try to make that whole movement as fluid, as effortless as you can. Good. Now we're going to do plank. We come out, and everything is straight. Toes pointed, arms are straight. Beautiful, and straight back. Good. Now as much as you can, you're going to curl the knees in towards the chest. From right here, curl the knees in towards the chest. As far as you can get a spine, come right back down all the way to squat. Knee curl. Good. Now, right here, right above. Good, let it be wherever it's at. It'll get smoother with practice. Good. And coming up to sitting. Walking the feet forward, curling the back, come down center, and right back. Grip down. Keep your core on the top of the ball, not down here, because your ball can pop out from under you. Leg stays up here on top of the ball. Good. Alright, one more before we get on the bar. Feet are in front. And this foot is going to go where that foot is. The other one's going to go out further. Yeah. And now we're going to switch places with those feet. Yeah. Switch places. Switch places. It's called speed skater. Switching. Switching. switching, then you can let that switch get as wide as you can. Everybody watch. Going straight across in a straight line. Compressing into my clothes. Like a speed skater. That same motion. Ready? Go. Nice. Ooh. You can, you can. Yeah, don't be so close to that ball. To put it on
out. Right now.
Speed skater. Very nice, very nice. Beautiful. Find yourselves on a bar. Say what? That is Squirrel Nut Zippers. Perennial favorites. All right. Now realize all of those movements are what created the work we've been doing on the bar. So I want you to notice the similarities in these moves now that you have a new context to process them in. Yes.
Why don't you give her yours? That was huge. Does that feel better, Tim? Okay. Is that better?
Okay. Everybody finding center. Making sure you're not too far away from the bar. You don't be stretching your arms out straight. You should be close so that your arms are relaxed. Closer to the wall. So your arms are relaxed. Yes, nice. Shoulders are soft. Feet are off the floor. Fingertips. And we're going to start with calibration. See where you're at. Let go. How long can you float? Count in seconds. 1, 2, 3. Once you can make it past 15 or 20, then you don't need to count anymore. Breathe. Accept wherever you are. We don't need any frustration in this room. It doesn't accomplish anything. We're here to feel and play and learn and grow. Leave that crit outside. Leave the poo-poo outside. Leave work outside. Right now, it's time to feel and play. Adults forgot how to play a long time ago. We got to remember. Beautiful. Beautiful. Fingers on the bar. Hip rock side to side. Find that heart center and let that heart center float still in space. If you float that heart center, it will loosen the low back, giving you more mobility, more sensation, more awareness. Beautiful. And speed it up. Breathe deep. Feel the center and move from your center. Beautiful. Notice what your center feels like, and we want to stay aware of that feeling for this entire session. Good. And hip rock front to back. Curling the pelvis under, arching it backwards. Make sure you're getting a good arch backwards to open that low back. Quadratus lumborum. That's the desk chair muscles. Sit in a chair all day, you know your quadratus lumborum. Breathing, feeling what it feels like to move from your center,
and speed it up.
Do you mind?
Close your eyes and notice if it feels any different. With our eyes closed, we become more aware of sensation. It becomes easier to focus on what we're experiencing. Good. Now combine those two movements, hip circles. Starting small, slowly finding a larger movement as the hips and spine soften. And reverse. Good. Now one circle in reverse, one circle then reverse. And so I'm going to use two words a lot today, luscious and delicious. And I want you to try to make every movement, every rep, luscious and or delicious. And luscious is like something that you want to eat, something savory. So we don't want to do movements like this. We want to do movements like this. That's luscious. Luscious is the nature of Tai Chi, ballet, flamenco, belly dance. Beautiful. All right, back to center. And now calibration. Find your balance. See if it feels any different. Use those hips. The hips move in the direction that you feel yourself falling. Heart goes in the opposite direction. Good. If you're a boss, hip rock with no hands. Is there such thing as a bossette? Stop picking the bossettes. So what?
Patrona.
Nice. So while you're wagging your tailbone, while you're balancing, what you're doing is you're increasing your center of gravity. You have a sphere inside your core. And when you're inside that sphere, you have your balance. You can feel your center. You can control your center. But when we move out, you lose control. So right now, about with this shift, we're making that sphere bigger. And now we're going to increase it from front to back. Hip rock, front to back, no hands. Or fingertips if you need them. Beautiful focus. I haven't seen any critics, no poo-poos, no I can'ts. Beautiful. Wrap the legs around to the left.
Holding the bar.
Holding the bar. Yes. Leg wrap, no bars. Definitely boss.
Things advanced.
Yeah. All right, so go as far around as you can. Feel that stretch. And now we're going to wrap all the way to the other side. Okay? So notice what your body has to do to get your legs all the way around. We're going to try to make it smooth, but we're going to do it a few more times. Let's go all the way to the other side. Okay, and again, all the way to the other side. Good. Now Shari's going to count them. Make them as smooth as you can.
Ready? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Breathe.
10, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15,
16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Sweet. How do you train anything? You make it harder. One hand.
One
hand? Yep.
I just moved my hand a little bit in the center, so you're allowed to change position.
Yep.
All right, ready to the left.
Best you can.
One.
You gotta use your other finger, use it.
Three. Four. Five.
Nice.
Six. Seven. Eight. Nine. Ten. 11. 12. 17,
18, 19, 20. Beautiful. Very nice work. Two hands. Coming on to the right hip. Boom. Not down onto the side, just onto the hip. Finding your balance. Load. Breathe.
Good. Ideally, your shoulders should be soft. Good job, Tammy. So that you're balancing, not holding yourself with your arms. Beautiful center. Back to the same head. Balance. One hand. Switch hands. Yep, you might need to adjust a little. Nice. Good, back to center. Alright, now this is just like hip rock, but you're going to go out to that side and back to center. We're not going to both sides. We're going all the way into that hip and right back. Ready? Count.
One. Two. Three.
Hold that core over the center of the bottle. That's what we're training right now, is your awareness of your core and keeping it over the center of the ball. That's where your control comes from.
Eight.
Beautiful.
Nine. Ten. 11. 12. 13.
14. 15. Good. Other side. Hip. Stall. Find that center. Beautiful. Up. And back to that hip. One hand. Nice. Switch hands. Stop. Beautiful. Two hands. Back up. And reps. That side. 15.
One. Two. Three. Four. Five. Six.
Very nice.
Seven. Eight. Nine. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15.
Beautiful. Okay, now we're going to take that movement all the way down to side kick, but I want you to pay very close attention to your right shoulder. When people learn side kick, they tend to do it like this, and you're going to go out. They go that way. That's not what we want to do. Come back up. What I want you to do is pay attention to this right shoulder. This right shoulder is going to go straight down. Notice the difference in the position of her body. Her core stays straight over the ball this way. This is where you want to be in side kick, not down here. All kinds of tension here, all kinds of other tension here. You want to be over the center. That shoulder is going to come straight down and then straight back up. Okay? So everyone go onto your right side. And that right shoulder is going to go straight down. Core stays over the center of the ball. Find your side kick. Foot goes above the height of the bar if you can get it there. Other foot, your right foot is to your knee. Your toe is to your knee. Beautiful. Hold it. Breathe. Beautiful. Gorgeous. Great. Soft but strong. Your body has far more power than you understand, and the only way to discover it is to challenge it. Beautiful. Up. Awesome. Same thing. Focus on that right shoulder. It's going to drop straight down. And side kick. Hold it. Breathe. Gorgeous. And up. Awesome. Now we're going to do our reps. As you're doing these reps, I want you to focus on that shoulder, dropping straight down every time. Drop down, drop down. Keep up the char as best you can, but let yourself be wherever you're at when you're ready.
One. Two. Three.
Beautiful.
Four. Six.
Fix your ball if you need to and drop right back in.
Seven. Eight. Nine. Ten. 11. 12. 13.
That would just...
17.
I couldn't read your lips.
18. 19. Last one.
Stay there. Stay there. Stay down. Good. That leg is your up position. Both feet stay where they're at, and you drop the legs down and raise them up. One, two,
three, four, five, six.
Breathe.
Seven.
We're going deep.
Eight. Nine. Ten. 11. 12. 13. 14.
Soft but strong.
15. 16. 17. 18.
Beautiful.
19. 20. 21. 22. 23. 24. 25. 26. 27. 28.
Called Sculpted Burn for a reason.
30. 31. 32. 33.
Take a break if you need to.
35. 36. 37.
38. 39. 40. Up. Beautiful. Stretch it. Stretch it. Stretch it.
Feel the burn.
Got to make sure you guys remember this class this week. Make sure you think about me tomorrow. Even if you're saying bad thoughts. All right, same thing on the other side. That left shoulder is going to drop straight down. Find your side stall. Find your center. Breathe. Soft but strong. Strength of your body, that gives it more strength. If you doubt it, that gives it less strength. Beautiful. Up. And we didn't do this on the other side, but just for fun, I know y'all are all bosses. Down your side kick. One hand. Yes, it can be dangerous, but if you protect yourself and you don't do anything silly and you find your way into it, look at that. Everybody's doing it. Nice. Okay, tricky time. Other hand. Yep, nice. You might have to reposition your right hand, that's fine.
do that hand to the center of your body and put it up there. And if you find that point where you're floating, you'll come up. There you go. Nice, nice, nice. Beautiful. Ah! Nice, nice, nice. You guys remember what was your name? 2.0? Michelle 2.0 came to do private sessions for a few weeks before she left to go to Vegas. She was doing one-handed side kicks. Like it was nothing. Booyah! Okay, so we're doing two hands. Side kicks on the side. That left shoulder going straight down, coming right back up. We're doing 20.
One.
Nice.
Two. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight.
Use your breath. Visualize the movement. Visualize what you want the movement to feel like. And notice that that visualization will affect the sensation of the body.
14, 15, 16, 17, 18.
Gorgeous. Stay there, stay down, stay down. And 40 raises. Go. Take
one,
a break if you need to.
Two. Three.
But see if you have more than you think you do.
Five. Six,
I know you have more than you think
seven,
you do.
Eight. Nine. 4 minutes. Beautiful. Hands back on the bar. Butts up. When your butt comes up, your legs should be straight. Your lower legs or your upper legs, I guess, your thighs. It should be straight down from your spine, and your core should be over the center of the ball. Beautiful. Tailbone down. But up. Down. Up. Three. Four. Five.
Go indeed.
7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15.
Shari decides how many y'all are doing this time.
Ooh, 17. Lucky for you, I've already done a class today. 19. 20. 21. 22,
23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 2 more, 29, 30.
Beautiful,
beautiful. Stretch it. You need to come down to stretch it, come down to stretch it. Why that burns the way it does, we don't really know, but it'll get you.
It does.
It'll get you. All right, back on the knees. And we got hip rock side to side. Wiggle that tailbone. Wiggle it. Just a little bit. Very nice, very nice. Everybody's just on point today. Don't even need me. That's the name of the game. That's the point. Make yourself obsolete. I think that's the nature of enlightenment. Right? Very nice. Hip rock front to back. This is going to feel weird, but just feel it. It's there. It's necessary for balance on your knees. What kind of music does your husband play?
It's like 60s and 70s. Americana rock.
Freebird.
Like very European.
Gotcha.
Beatles, Beach Boys, ELO.
And Circles. So they're like a cover band kind of thing? No, it's just that's
their genre. Yeah, I mean, if you had to get them, you know, get my husband around something record.
So you're married to a rock star.
Well, we're working on it.
Oh, my favorite.
Well, they have a record label and they just signed a big booking deal.
Reverse. Awesome.
Yeah, so they're about to be on the road.
That's going to be interesting to figure out how we're going to work like that.
We're going to rip it
on.
Oh, that's awesome.
Reverse. That's awesome. I grew up traveling with
them. Yeah, my brother was a pro bull rider, so my niece and nephews traveled.
Good. Back to center. And calibration. Notice where your balance is at. Use those hips to keep your heart floating over the center. Anybody's knees are tired, step down and stretch them. You cannot balance yourself on top of this ball like a stick. You've got to let your hips be soft and move and float under you, hip rock style, in order to keep your heart floating over the center. I like Angie's rocking her Buddha hands. Beautiful. Beautiful. All right. Now let's do a boss move. Stretch your knees if you need to. And we're back on our knees. Superman.
This is going to be a sore.
Step one up.
Add your tailbone's coming up. See if you can bring your knees just a little bit behind your core. Butt stays tucked in. Back down. Butt up. Knees come just a little bit behind the core. Back down. Beautiful. Again. Knees back, butt in. Yes. Gorgeous. One more. Nice. And now we're going to take that same movement. Butt's going to come up. Feet reach away from you and let the body slide down diagonally. Beautiful. But try not to plop. Body long and straight. Feet together. Toes pointed. Gorgeous. Da-da-da-da. Superman. Superlady. Good. Now when you, now before we try to come up, we're going to do pull-ups. And watch your arms. You can pull up above the bar, as far as you can comfortably, chest coming in towards it, and straight back. That's one. Yeah.
Two.
Yes. Three. Do not pull up so hard that you're really struggling.
Four.
Five. Six. Seven.
Good. Back. Now we're going to use that movement coming up. You're going to go in that direction. Once your chest gets up, then your knees start coming in. Let your chest get up first. Yes. Fix your ball.
Position. Good.
Nice. And butt up. Feet go away. Down with the Superman. Good. One up strong. Up. Knee curl. Nice. Don't worry about how pretty it is. We're making the body stronger. Fix your balls. And number three, down. Got to go up to get down. What's that flop hitting? And up.
Hey, up. Cut. Cut.
Stretch knees out. Good work. All right. Y'all are gonna hate me. Knee wraps. Start on our knees, and we're gonna learn how to come down from the knees and get up to the knees effortlessly. And we're gonna take a lot of work to learn effortlessness. That is the nature of it. You practice tension, you can practice struggle, you become very skilled at tension and struggle. If you practice effortless, if you practice grace, you become very skilled at effortless grace. From right here, we're gonna come down onto the left hip. Yep. And you're gonna come down just far enough, just far enough that your feet are out from under you. Right? I want your core to still stay over the center of the ball. Good. We're not going down in the side kick. Perfect. Now, I want you to get back up to your knees as effortlessly as you can from there. Nice.
It's a lot of the hip
rock.
Start over. Lifting your butt, yeah. So you can bring your foot up.
So talk them through 10, at least 10 of those. And if it doesn't feel like much, have them do some more. I'm a helper.
Okay. So when you come down. Come down your chest, bring your foot free, bring them back up, the hip drop, and lift your butt. spot so that your foot can go under.
So what you're doing is when you're starting your whole body.
One. Two. Good. Three. Four. Five. Six.
Okay. Come down a little further to your
arm. Seven. Eight. Nine. Last one. Ten. Okay, on this side. Do a couple slow first. Just coming down to that right foot. And your feet are my feet already on the ball. We're just right here. You don't need this to come out or anything. Pull around, lift up. One more slow.
Knees to go to the other side, and you're going to start just with that little rock.
Down to the left foot, bring him around. Up top, left leg comes under first, pick up. When you're coming up, you want to still keep your knees apart, that way your balance will be better as you're up. Okay, down. One. Two. Three. Four.
You guys feel it?
Ready? keeping the knee straight.
Two.
Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven.
Breathe.
Eight. Nine. Ten. 11. 12.
Keep that leg as high as you can comfortably.
14. 15. 16. 17. 18. 19. 20. 21. 22.
raising the feet up.
So for doubles, pull your arms forward a little bit so your feet come off the ground. And one, two, three,
like her,
four,
her favorite double
five,
swim.
Six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20.
And relax. Elbows to the ball, hands to the floor, breathe. Breathe. Gently rocking back and forth. Spreading your legs out so you can roll back up into a squat. Beautiful work, ladies. Beautiful work. And because this is the last class, and also just because I love it, we're in with parkour work. So everybody climb the parkour. So we want to be not near the wall for this stuff. And we're going to start sitting facing each other. Yeah, it's better to do it this way. Okay, one person's feet can be on the other person's ball. So you're going to find your balance. Your balance should be over the center of your ball. Your weight should not be falling in towards your partner. You should be balanced and just barely putting pressure on your partner's ball. You'll find out why very soon. Good. So supporters, you are responsible for your partner. You help them. You do not let them go down in flames by themselves. You dive and try to catch them. Try to help them. But what you're going to do now is you're going to begin to move your ball. Supporters, begin to move your ball and gently play with your partner's balance. See where their boundaries are. What you're going to do is you're going to search for their weakness. You're going to search for their weakness in a gentle, friendly way. Plenty of time to get eaten later. Should let go at the right time. If you know you're going down, give up with your feet down. Now don't bite the dust. I would say fight it, like don't fight going down, but you've got to fight it for sure. Once you know you're going, give in. Accept the ground. Reach out to the ground and accept the ground in. Never try to hold the ground away from you when you fall. That's how you break something. You will always reach out and you accept the ground like you're cradling an egg. Good. Start moving them in even more. If they haven't lost their balance yet, try to see if you can make them lose their balance.
then catch them. This is the beginning of what we call heckling. And heckling is friendly learning.
Yeah, nice. So pull your ball backwards. You have an order, you got an energy. And you pull them backwards, she's coming in. She doesn't have a balance in there. Can you feel if she pulls her ball away, you're gone? Feel that?
No.
Pull your ball back. Keep going.
No, girl. It looked like her voice was. Shut up. Beautiful. Switch. Start out as a stable base, as a stable support. Balancers, remember you want your balance over your ball. And supporters, gently begin heckling, exploring how big is their sphere, where is their boundary of control, the sphere of influence. And heckle a little more. Make them earn it. Good save.
You can mess with her more than that, Tammy.
Balancers, see how much more can you float? Yep, she's got you now. If she went back to do the dog.
She would. I wouldn't.
Good, good, nice. Okay, beautiful. Now one person's both feet is up, and the other person is going to do 1 foot. The base is going to do 1 foot when the other person's ball. One's going to stay on the floor. So both your feet are up on her. Sure.
I thought I could, and then I was like, I'm a little over here. Yes.
Yes.
Okay, 1 and 1 or 2? Should I put both my feet in the middle, or like, can we?
Either way.
Got it, Marcus. Got it. You got it.
Yes, and don't bend your arm. Bend your arm.
teach you the science.
I'm going to have a ball throw.
Everybody come together for me. Circle up.
Awesome work. I wish I had a whole bunch more time. Not always, every time I'm with people tonight, but I'm sure we'll be back again. And you regulars, if you ask them to, it'll be more likely. Yeah, let's come back. So that's what we're teaching. We have right now, so we do have private phone. And we do have DVDs for sale. I sell those for $10, $20 DVD. Char wants to give one away for a balance chef. So end with balance on our knees on the bar. Whoever does the longest gets a DVD.
I did nothing but eat and drink all week.
Just give a disclaimer,
right? You're a disclaimer.
And Shara doesn't count, but I am going to let whoever wins go until one of them falls. Because we cut it off last time.
Oh, yeah.
And she could have had a chance to beat you. But we cut it off, so whoever's left, you're going to go against Shara. All right, ready? Just for a couple times, test it out. Find your center. Once you're out, you can keep trying with no problem. But you're no longer in the running. Not yet. I'm letting you feel your center. And if it goes on long enough, I do reserve the right to heckle logically. Heckle with words. Good. Ready? All right. So we're going to do a countdown. 3, 2, 1. After one, hands come off. If you touch the floor or the bar, you are out, but you're welcome to keep practicing if you want to. Here we go. And 3, 2, 1.
Oh, my gosh.
I mean, wow.
But I want to give her the chance to beat her because, you know, it's like she deserves it. And I don't think I've ever timed Char on her mat, so.
Maybe you're on that.
Yeah. I wanted to officially break the world record for standing on a ball.
Oh.
Five and a half hours.
There was a guy on Fox and Friends, not too recent, but standing on ball. Right. I didn't know that you did that.
No, yeah. I've been doing that for years. But the thing is, like, how long? And the world record is 5.5 hours.
I'm starting to shake.
Yeah, now you've been shaking for a while, huh? Uh-huh. I'm amazed. Right? Oh.
I know. Now my shins hurt.
Nice job, ladies. Yeah.
Thank you.
All right. Have a good one.
Thank you.
Very, very nice. I'm about to start heckling soon.
My shins are about to fall. Mine are hurting so bad. Should we call it truth?
Yeah, right after you come down.
You go first.
That was close. That was like 5 minutes.
Thank you.
Body juggling, sculpt, and burn. Oh. Booyah. Rock it out, ladies. Peace.